Hawaii ranks first in the nation when it comes to pedestrian fatalities among senior citizens, and it ranks fifth in the nation in pedestrian deaths overall. As KITV4's Jody Leong tells us, the state today launched its second annual Pedestrian Safety Month to encourage safe habits among both pedestrians and drivers.
These are a few of the faces of pedestrians who have been killed on Oahu's roadways this year. 87-year-old Dickie Lau hit by a car at 10th Avenue on Ka'au Street July 5th. 76-year-old Setsuko Furuya hit by a trolley in Waikiki on June 27th. 86-year-old Kirino Agisanda killed in a hit-and-run on Farrington Highway at Awamoku Street May 23rd.
These are lives. These are people. These are children. These are grandparents. These are mothers and fathers.
And they're the reason for Pedestrian Safety Month in August, the only such campaign in the nation. State and city agencies are encouraging drivers and pedestrians to take responsibility for their safety and the safety of others on the road.
It's vital that motorists are observant, especially crosswalks or intersections.
The Honolulu Police Department says that goes for pedestrians too.
You're not going to win if you get struck by a vehicle. So when crossing the street, you know, they have to look both ways and double check to make sure it's clear.
But too often it is elderly pedestrians who die on our roadways, and police are urging drivers to be on the lookout for seniors.
It's a little bit different for them, you know, maybe with vision or not being as mobile as they were in the younger days. How wide the street is, how long does it take to cross.
It isn't clear what happened to Kirino Agisanda as he got off the city bus and was hit by a dark pickup truck on Farrington Highway 2 months ago. But as time has passed, the case has stalled, and police say it is unlikely the hit and run will ever be solved.
And we don't have any witnesses that are willing to come forward to help us out.
Jody Leong, KITV4 News.
WalkWise Hawaii has been focusing on senior pedestrian education. The number of senior fatalities has remained at an average of 39% for the past 3 years, compared to 60% 10 years ago.